guys, it's Lauren Day Makeup, and I thought I would do a bit of a hair update and also some curly hair tips. So it's been about 10 days since I got my hair dyed with this red, really bright red in my hair, and also underneath I got the red as well. The red underneath is still, as you can see, very vibrant. It has faded a little bit, but it's still kind of very much that kind of red colour that I got when I first got it. The red in my fringe, however, has faded a little bit. Not as much as I thought it would fade, which is good because I didn't really want it to fade at all, but I know that it's red and I knew that it was going to fade. So unfortunately it's faded a little bit, but I've been using a colour kind of protectant shampoo, and that's by Tresemme, so that's helped really well. So if you haven't seen my channel before, welcome. A lot of comments on my channel about my hair and people wanting to know how curly my hair is, and is it naturally curly, and how do I get my ringlets, and there's all the kind of the questions that I get generally. I guess having curly hair is, it is kind of fairly unique. A lot of people have straight hair, so it is sometimes can be very hard to manage. So any girls with curly hair will know what I'm talking about. It can be very hard to manage. So I have a few tips for you guys that I use on my hair, and maybe that will help you. Tip number one, or the best tip that I can give you to have curly, if you have curly hair, is to always work with the curls when that your hair is wet, because when your hair is wet, that's when the curls is easiest to form the curls when they're wet, because that's kind of in its natural state. So every morning in the shower I always wet my hair and I put a comb through it, and the comb that I use is like an afro comb. I use this one, and this one's by Avon, and I will comb out my hair while I'm in the shower when it's wet, because you should only really comb out your hair or brush your hair when it's wet. Never brush your hair when it's dry, because it will make your hair really frizzy, and it's a nightmare. So that's my number one tip, is never brush your hair when it's dry. Always brush your hair when it's wet, and try to use a comb as well that will help with breakage. So once I have brushed out my hair in the shower with my afro comb, it's generally pretty wet. I'll wrap my hair in a towel while I'm getting ready, and then what I will do is I will then wet my hair with a little bit of a concoction that I've created, and basically this is conditioner mixed with warm water. And what I generally do before I get out of the shower is I will kind of blast my hair, or just rinse off your hair with as cold a water as you can stand, because the cold water will close off the cuticles and it will just help with the frizziness. So I generally blast my hair with a little bit of cold water, and then after I get out of the shower I will brush my hair out with my little afro comb, and I generally part my hair in the center, and then I will spray this so that I can create the curls. And then once my hair is wet to the consistency that I want, so it's not too wet, but it's wet so that you can manage it to create the curls. So then you want to grab your favorite curling kind of product. The curl product that I use, and this is definitely my second curl tip, is to use a product on your hair that is designed for curls. The curl product that I use is by Sunsilk. This is the new packaging, and it's the curl definition. It's the curl, and they now call it the curl booster balm, but you'll be able to find a similar product to this. This is the consistency of it here. It's just like kind of like a gel kind of consistency. Now you can also use mousse as well. I used to use mousse on my hair for years and years. They used to have a really good mousse by Pantene, which is the curl defining mousse, and I used to use that on my hair. But my sister always has used this product on her hair, and this product can be used on wet hair and on dry hair. So if your hair is dry and it's already got the curls in it, add a little bit of this into the palm of your hands, work it around your hands, and then kind of grab your hair and use it as a scrunchy kind of tool, and that will help to define the curls. But the way that I use it is I add the product into my hair while it's wet, and then while your hair is wet, that's when it's in its natural state for you to be able to curl your hair. So if you want to kind of find out how I get these curls, I have like a detailed kind of curly hair tutorial on how I create these particular ringlets. But basically when my hair is wet, I will add the curl, the Sunsilk curl booster balm, into my hair, and then I will grab each section of my hair and just twist around my fingers like this, and then that creates the curls. And I can do sections smaller than this, you can do sections larger than this, depending on the type of curl that you want to get and the length of your hair. So that's how I create these kind of curls that I do in my hair kind of every day. If I don't have time to do the curls or I couldn't be bothered, then what I generally do is still get the curl booster balm, put it into my hair, and then I will lightly scrunch my hair. I put it kind of all over my hair and then just scrunch my hair. You can also then use a blow dryer and use like a diffuser. Generally, I don't ever blow dry my hair when it's in this curly state, because my good curly hair tip that I have for you guys is to let your curls dry naturally, because adding heat to the curls, it's kind of like adding heat to your curls is kind of like a no-no. Like, that's what creates the frizz. The heat and the humidity, that's what creates frizz. So by putting heat on it with a blow dryer, it's going to create extra frizz, which you don't want. You want to stay away from frizz, because generally if your hair is really curly like mine, frizz is the enemy and your hair is just will become a huge big frizz ball. So generally what I do is put the curl stuff in and then let my hair dry naturally. It may take a couple of hours depending on how thick your hair is, but generally the curls will last longer and they'll just be in a natural kind of nicer state and they'll just look really, really nice. Another tip that I have, apart from this, is a good tip that I have come up with like recently in the last year or so, is adding the conditioner to the water, because I used to always just use normal water, but by adding the conditioner, it really helps you to create the curls and it helps to tame the frizz as well. So to help with the frizz, like generally I always use a hairspray or something like that after I've done my hair. So the hairspray that I use at the moment is Tresemme, and this is a really good hairspray. It's really cheap, and this is the salon finish extra hold. You need extra hold when you've got curly hair like me, so that will help you with any kind of flyaways, because you'll generally get flyaways on the top of your head and maybe a little bit on the ends of your hair, but generally I find the top of my head, that's kind of where the breakage is, and that's where you'll get flyaways. So this helps. So I highly recommend this hairspray. It's really, really good. Another thing for flyaways, I use this product, and it's by Schwarzkopf, but there's lots of different ones of this, and it's like an anti frizz serum, and it's like a liquid. You put a little bit into your hands, a couple of squirts, and then you can put it anywhere where you've got the frizz. Like I generally have a little bit of frizz here, so any of those kind of baby hairs around your face, any of those fine hairs, or you can always put a little bit on the ends of your fingers and run it a little bit on the ends of your hair as well. Grab a section of the curls. And then if you just go like this, and it will just help to define the ends of the curls like that. See how it's much more defined? And that's what you can do with your hair, like at the ends of your hair or anywhere at the top section of your hair that has flyaways. You can use that kind of anti-frizz serum. I find that's really good. It's kind of sticky, it gets all over your hands, but it's definitely well worth it. Also, another hair care tip for washing your hair, which I find is really good, is to always find a shampoo that is for damaged hair or for dry hair, because usually curly hair is very dry and damaged. So the shampoo that I'm using at the moment, and I change this all the time, is this shampoo from L'Oreal, and it is especially for dry hair. So any product for dry or damaged hair, I would definitely recommend. You want to get something that's moisturizing, that says that it adds moisture to the hair, because that's really what curly hair is lacking, is moisture. So definitely use that. There's a lot of conditioners and shampoos out there that are designed for curly hair, but if you have a lot of curl in your hair like me and you don't want it to be too curly, then generally the curly shampoos, they'll hydrate your hair and they'll be moisturizing, but they will definitely add more curl to the hair. So if you have like wavy hair and you want more curl, I would definitely get a shampoo that's designed for curly hair, because it will add more curl or define the curls to your hair. But if you're like me, or if you're like any of the African American ladies who have really curly hair, you'll want to stick with a shampoo or conditioner that's really moisturizing, because you want your hair to be hydrated, and that way it will hold the curls more and it won't be so frizzy as well. So a tip for curly hair which I have is not to tie your hair back. I generally always wear my hair out. It's like a butterfly clip. Something like this would be good, or you know, smaller clips kind of like this. Definitely to tie your hair back, because generally a lot of ladies who and young girls as well who have curly hair that don't want to deal with having curls, they'll tie their hair back or slick it back. You'll see they'll have it in a high ponytail or something like that. And all that will do to your hair is create a lot of breakage around the top part of your hair. For years and years when I was a teenager, I used to tie my hair back. I used to slick it back. I didn't know what to do with it. For school, we used to have to tie our hair back, and I used to always tie my hair back. And now I have a lot of breakage at the back of my hair because I used to tie my hair back. So that's definitely a tip that I would have, is to try to wear your hair out as much as you can. Obviously, if you have a job where you have to wear your hair up, then wear it up. But do definitely wear like a hair clip, because it's not so stressful on your hair, and it will help with the breakage of your hair and make sure that you don't damage your hair in any way. So find out more tips about curly hair by going to this website called naturallycurly.com. They have lots of tips, and there's all lots of ladies on there who have curly hair like us, and you can get lots of tips as well. So thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you guys for always leaving sweet comments about my hair. I really appreciate you guys. Thank you for subscribing. If this is the first video that you've seen of me, welcome to my channel, and please don't forget to subscribe to find more videos, makeup tutorials, beauty videos, videos about celebrities. So check out my page, and to find out more about how I curl my hair, you can watch my curly hair how to ringlets tutorial. So thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate you guys. Much love. Bye. Of